Brahmaji's Moha Bhangam. After the killing of Agha, Krishna and the Gopas went to the river banks. They were hungry and the hour was late. Each boy took out his own packet of food. They all sat in a circle and Krishna sat in their midst. While they were thus engrossed in eating their food, the cattle strayed away along the river bank. After some time, the Gopa boys missed their cattle and wore worried frowns on their faces. They got up to search for them. But Krishna said, "No, don't bother. Sit down and finish your meal. I will go and look for them. I'll soon be back." So the boys went back to their meal and Krishna went to look for the missing calves. Now Brahmaji had witnessed Krishna's tricks and his extraordinary strength and prowess. He felt a longing to experience Krishna's powers for himself. So in a moment of mischief, he hid all the calves in a mountain cave. Krishna searched high and low in the forest, the hills and the valleys. But nowhere could he find even a trace of the calves. So he returned to the riverbank to report the matter to the Gopas. There, to his utter astonishment, he found the Gopas missing too. What was he to make of these strange disappearances? He meditated deeply and then came to know that it was all a trick of Brahmaji to test his divinity. He smiled and decided that he would please Brahma and at the same time give an infinite experience of bliss to the mothers of Gopas and to the cows. So he multiplied himself and assumed the forms of the Gopas and their tender calves. He assumed their exact size, the exact number of hands and feet, holding an equal number of staffs, horns and flutes, wearing the same clothes. And then he, in his different forms, copied to the last detail their individual behaviors, qualities, names, appearances, ages, voices, even their characteristic movements. When it was dusk and the sun was preparing to set for the night, Krishna and all the Krishna Gopas and the Krishna calves wended their way back to their homes. When the mothers heard the sound of the flutes and the horns, they came running out to embrace their children. They hugged the boys close to their hearts and fed them with tremendous joy. The cows too showed more tenderness towards their calves. Vrindavana was bathed in ecstatic love. The Lord, who is the essence of all beings, thus received the love of many thousand human and animal mothers. He in turn filled their devoted hearts with supreme bliss, which arises from a total, all-consuming love. Nobody noticed any change except that the mothers started loving their boys more and more. Krishna, along with the mind-born Krishna Gopas and Krishna calves, would every morning go to the forest as usual. Every house, every family in Vraja was filled with an atmosphere of the highest kind of love. And thus the days passed till almost a year was over. One day, as the cows were grazing on the summit of the Govardhana, they felt a tremendous upsurge of love for their calves, which were grazing near Vraja. Breathlessly, the cows rushed down the hillside to the calves. Balarama was watching all this and he thought, "Never have I seen the cows display such great love towards their calves. Even the mothers love the Gopas more than they ever did." Then addressing Krishna, he said, "These calves and their keepers, the cowherd boys, have all started looking like you, Krishna. What is the mystery? I am baffled." Krishna then explained to him all that had happened. Brahma now became curious to see how Krishna had met the tricky situation he had put him into. So he mounted his swan and went to see. And lo, a more puzzled person there never was. For before him, he saw two sets of Gopas and their calves. One lord which he had imprisoned in the caves and one lord which was as usual tending the animals in the forest. Just as a hazy darkness disappears in the total darkness of the night, just as the light of the glowworm disappears in the light of the morning sun, so too Brahmaji's Maya seemed to have disappeared in the overpowering Maya of Bhagavan. Brahma had been caught by his own Maya. He was dazed and confused. Suddenly the haze before his eyes lifted and he saw the gopas and the calves assuming the dark complexion of Krishna. Then he saw them all in the form of Sri Vishnu, four-armed, holding the divine conch, discus, mace and lotus, beaming with resplendent glory. The confusion now cleared and he understood what had happened. Brahmaji then alighted from his swan and bowing deeply prostrated before Krishna. Then he rose and offered praise to the Lord. Brahmaji went thrice around Krishna, mounted his swan and disappeared, and along with him also disappeared the Krishna gopas and Krishna calves. Under the trees were now sitting the original boys and their calves were grazing not far away. Krishna joined them for the meal and laughingly showed them the corpse of the python which he had only an hour ago killed. As evening drew near, the gopas picked their way back to Vraja. There they related to the elders how Krishna had killed Aghasura. They remembered nothing of what had happened to them meanwhile, since they had been under Brahmaji's spell. Only Krishna and Balarama knew the whole story and they kept it secret. The people of Vraja treasured all of Krishna's deeds in their memories and turned them into songs. And yet they remained ignorant of his divine nature.